a lot of fun being on set with these two.
I can clearly see the strong chemistry that they've had.
Friendship between Reece and Charlie is just so solid.
And them two got together, bonded behind a tree.
Actually being absolute nutters and taking banter against each other.
Balls to the walls, mental.
Amazing being part of it all.
You know, they both think outside the box.
It's quite a warped sense of humour.
When they come together, like, the set becomes super vibrant.
Oh my God, they're like a little comedy act.
So my personal favourite would have to be The Wolf, mainly because it was a sort of a horror film that involved the werewolf, and they are fantastic. So, and that was also great fun, just getting to run up and down chasing after Chris Hampshire in a wolf costume with everyone sort of looking on and wondering what we were doing. But it was probably The Wolf, I think.
Reece came to me and said, do you want to work on my new silent film, The Wolf? I was like, wow, silent film, that's new. Yeah, we'll give that a go. So he brought me in as an actor, and there I met Charlie. So we had arranged to meet up in a coffee shop. We're going through the whole schedule to go through the whole thing. And found out that Charlie's just as much of a nutter as Reece, which kind of makes sense since them two have been together for so long, 20 years friendship, shall I say. absolutely nutters.
I met Reece about 2.5 years back, 3 years possibly, and he was doing a production called Wolf at the time, The Wolf, and they were looking for a granddad figure. As you can see, I look more like a teenager now, but at the time they were looking for a granddad, and I happened to be the person that did that for them. You know, it was very enjoyable.
So when we see the end results of the films that we've made, they're always lots of fun to see them, because it's like a small 20 minute version of probably a 4 hour filming session that is covered by numerous amounts of bloopers because we can't stop laughing.
Okay, sorry, let's do that again. I'm sorry. I just love how he says it.
Right, you two, out now.
I'm sorry. Right,
Jim,
let's just start from when he gets in the car.
I'll just call the police on my super amazing new phone, which has 70,000 free data. Right, 9.
70,000 free data. Right.
You both are going to prison, and I hope your cellmates beat you to a pulp.
Nah, they won't touch me. They won't know where I've been.
My face is too beautiful for prison.
Archie, you just beat him to a pulp. Won't they add it to your charges?
Something went wrong there.
He quickly cut me off.
Oh yeah, cut him off and I was like, oh shit.
Alright, let's cut it there.
So it's always good fun to watch something you've helped create back on screen, even if you don't like seeing yourself back on screen, but that's, you know, it's a completely different matter entirely. But yeah, it's always lots of fun to watch something we filmed together.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Are you guys calling about a missing woman?
Yes, we did.
One of those rainy days, I was at a school and waiting to teach these brats how to play the guitar, and I'd received the iMessage from him saying that he's got the ideal role for me. The role as Eric in Cash in a Pond. So I got all excited in the foyer and don't want to teach anymore because passion is acting, music comes second.
And why would I want to do that?
Well, you see, Eric, I have bills that need paying and I could really use the extra cash.
Lester, let me confess something to you here. I'm glad you're suffering, because if you're unhappy, I'm very happy.
Yeah, look, Eric, I know you don't like me, but...
Oh, Lester, I fucking despise you!
Then I read the script and I thought, God, there's a lot of dialogue here. And I remember messaging him back and going, hope you're going to be quite easy with me to like recite these lines because there's a lot of work to be done here. He was like, no worries, mate. We're going to have fun on the day. Do what you want, you know. So I thought, all right, this is the role for me.
What do you want, Lester, you dick brain?
Oh, hi, Eric. Okay, I got some good news and I got some bad news.
Tell me the good news.
Okay, well, the good news is that the kidnapper wanted some extra money, and I got it.
And the bad news?
The money has been stolen.
Oh, Lester, you idiot! You bag of shit!
Don't worry, I'll get it back.
You better, we only have till tomorrow!
Then, along came the detective.
Who the fuck is that?
Hi.
Oh, hey, Albert.
Cash in the Pond, where I played a detective with a hidden personality trait, which was lots of fun to play. And that's also where I met Aeson and we were introduced to Lester, as he said it quite a few times. That was interesting. I'm fairly certain the neighbourhood thought he was being murdered half the time.
For fuck's sake, Lester!
One of the films that I'm kind of gutted that I wasn't part of was one of Reece's feature films called Cash in the Pond. It was very interesting and I would have loved to kind of be part of it, but I didn't know them back then, so gutted with not being part of that.
Hello, Alice.
So I had the privilege of working with Reece and Charlie about 2 years ago now. Thanks to social media, Reece found me on Instagram and wanted to find out whether I'll be involved in one of his projects. And of course, he sent me the script. It was amazing. And then I met them face to face, and that's where you kind of know when you can work with someone. So far, he's been one of the best directors I've worked with. Super friendly on set. He knows what he wants. He knows what he wants from the character. And you know, you just deliver it there and then with them. It just makes everything so much easier. They're great.
Hello, Richard.
Chastain, you sneaky mare. Is this all you're doing?
It was.
Well, thanks for saving my balls.
In time.
So, Reece asked me to go on to play Michael Hare in Wonders of Alice. And when I got the script, I've seen stitches. Actually, Reece and Charlie and I were in a pub. We were going through the script and Reece was there reading out our lines and I was trying to eat my food and I just couldn't eat the food because I was too busy laughing because of what he was saying. It was absolutely hilarious. But then, only then on the set, I realised that my co-star, Lauren, I had already known from a previous project. So we got on like a house on fire, which I hope shone through in the actual film. And absolutely made it absolutely hilarious.
Ah, Richard, feeling late as ever.
Yeah, I don't like you.
Late!
No, Rich, what brings you to our neck of the woods?
Well, you know me. Every time I see you three, it's always by accident.
Because it's a nice surprise.
No, because it hurts to look at your face.
Fancy a copper, Rich?
I'm good, cheers, Doreen.
Who's this pretty thing?
Oh, where are my manners, everybody? This is Alice.
Alice? Alice!
Who the fuck is Alice?
We have to be somewhere.
Well, we've got to find
the... Oh, a brand new watch. We're looking for a brand new watch. I've ran out and we've got to try and sell some more. You know what it's like. Keep your mouth shut.
I don't think what you just said is true.
I think you're both up to something.
Oh, for goodness sakes, leave him alone. You creepy, miserable fox.
Shut it! I want to know what you're both up to.
20 years, I think, Reese and Charlie. I like to call him Charles. It sounds so posh. 20 years they've been together. I mean, that's longer than a marriage, and I think it's incredible, and you can see the chemistry between them. I mean, I met them a few years ago on set, and I didn't even know sort of, you know, their friendship or anything, how close they were. And I remember just watching them and thinking, oh my God, they're like a little comedy act. And that was before I even spoke to them. Just absolutely love them to bits. And they managed to persuade me to do the wonders of Alice. First, I have to say, I was like, no, I'm only a supporting artist. I'm only a film extra. I'm not gonna, I'm doing no acting. But I mean, how could I resist the charm of Charles and Reese's smile? Well, that was it. It was over. Before I knew it, I was sitting there in a cafe with a script. No, I don't know where she is. I've not heard anything from her. Oh, she's just walked in. Alice, I'm so happy to see you. Thank God you're back. Oh, I'm safe. I'm so sorry. It's okay. Oh, I love you so much. I'm so sorry. I was gonna play an alcoholic mum, basically dress mutton as lamb, or was it lamb as mutton? No, mutton as lamb, yeah. And I had great fun. Absolutely great fun choosing my outfit. I was very impressed with Reese that he was able to direct me not only in what to wear, but also with my lines. And I just was drawn to him so much that I was even happy to do the filming in my house. You know, he called me up and he was like, oh, I've got to ask you something, you know, would you mind? You know, we're in a bit of a pickle, we need to find somewhere to film. And I didn't even think twice about having them in my home. That's how comfortable they make me feel.
I've been involved and helped them in quite a few productions, you know, obviously some that I couldn't be involved in, but they've done obviously The Wonders of Alice, which was a great joy playing the King. And you can see that him and Charles have got a fantastic bond together, you know, on camera together. On Archie and Jim, they've got such a, you know, chemistry together that they, you know, remind me so much of the young ones. Aid Edmondson and Rick Mell, that is them to a T, you know, very gifted.
Ow. 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 Ow.
Megan of Knot.
Oh, please.
Rise from the dead so we can be reunited. Wake up, Megan of Knot. Wake up, you little pain of shit!
Archie, sorry to ruin this weird Charlie thing that's going on right now, but you do know your hamster is dead. She's not asleep.
I know that, you testicle. Why do you think we're doing this?
To make ourselves look less stupid.
Exactly. Now carry on.
Okay.
Megan of Knot. Awaken.
Awaken. Get up.
Oh, why don't you just wake up and stop making me look like a twat?
I could see from the very beginning what a close bond they had, and ever since on all the productions I've worked with both of them, I can clearly see the strong chemistry that they've had. It's lovely to watch their friendship and relationship. They just bounce off each other. They're such a good double act, and I'm really proud to have met both of them and worked with them both.
What's going on here? If we said nothing, would you still analyse us?
Yes.
Well, then you better get analysing.
Okay. So we have a bloody bag. You two are filthy and wet and covered in blood yourselves. We have a bit of a tissue, which is written in crayon, saying, here is where we're going to dump the body, and not to forget the AAA batteries. That seems fine to me. I'll let you be on your way. Thank you, gentlemen.
What?
So, Reece called me again, and he said to me, oh, I've got this ideal role for you, the posh guy in the Archie and Jimmy series. And I thought, you know what? All right, I'll give it a go. So he sent me the script, I liked it. Got my lady involved, Manisha. She came down, played my fiance. We had a little picnic in Regent's Park. Reece turned up with his mate.
Oh, I love cheese, and I love you too.
I love you too, my dear, but I love the cheese more.
What are you going to do, Archie?
I'm going to be a man best.
What was that?
That was really weird.
Came out and told me, right, this is what's going to happen. It's cheese day. So he gave me the mature cheddar cheese and we got busy with it. Yeah, me and the missus, you know, had a little fun with the cheese before Reece came in and set the whole context of the film and what needs to be done. And that was a right laugh running around, and that came out really well.
Can I help you?
Well, no, but can I have some of that cheese?
Oh no, we can't do that, I'm afraid.
Why?
Because it's cheese day!
Too bad, I'm having it.
Honey, please do something, he's taking our cheese.
Well, we can't ask him to leave, we're too polite.
Well, honey, try anything, please.
Well, here goes nothing. Please, sir, can you leave?
Nah.
Well, that didn't work. Dawn.
Honey, please do anything or else I'm leaving you for the rich neighbour across the street.
You can't do that. He has better cheese than me.
Exactly.
So all of the stuff that you worked on, so a lot of the Archie and Jim, and I just remember watching it and I just thought, it was just balls to the walls, mental comedy. And I just felt like it's something you'd rarely see, that kind of comedy. And the fact that he has an idea and he just runs with it, and so he doesn't really, he just goes for it, and there's no deviant, there's no, I don't know if I want to do this. He's just like, oh, I have an idea, let's just fucking do it. And then eventually getting to meeting Charlie, so when we did the seeing the Wonders of Alice at the premiere, and so actually finally getting to meet him there, and I was just astounded by how those guys bond, they work off each other, and the fact that they've been friends for over like 20 years, it's just, you can really tell it, and so, because they just know each other inside and out, and the fact that they just like bounce things off each other, and so you feel like you should do a comedy series just about them rather than as the characters of Archie and Jim.
No, you can't, because I'm the best pest in the West.
Is that right?
Yeah,
is that right? I'll tell you what you are to me. You are a slimy, arrogant little...
What the hell is going on here?
I just couldn't stop laughing from doing that, even though it was like a couple of hours of shooting. It was definitely one of the most fun experiences I'd ever had.
Ooh, yeah, let's do this one together. We can both look like ladies.
Oh, Jim, stop talking rubbish.
God, Archie, for once in your life, will you stop being so boring? God!
Boring? Jim, did you just call me boring?
Yes.
Ah, oh, fuck it, Jim, selfie me.
Right.
Archie and Jim, and I have to say, I think because the friendship between Reece and Charlie is just so solid, that's why it works, and they're so passionate about what they do that it just comes through in their work. And yeah, it's, you know, it's a funny comedy series, but I feel like they do take it really seriously, but because of how their vision is on it, it's just amazing. And you know, every time you watch it, you just laugh at the ideas, because you're like, where do these ideas come from?
Reece at a premiere of 11 about 2 years ago with a friend, Renee, and he gave me a card, went up home as you do, and had a look on YouTube at Archie and Jim. Absolutely fell in love. I was in absolute stitches. I find their comedy quite so natural, and it's like, it's fun, and there's nothing forced, or, and the humour for me in the very beginning, the first couple of episodes, I was drawn to the fact that I compared them to the young ones back in the day. It's quite a warped sense of humour, but for myself, I just find it, you know, it's hilarious. As people, the two guys, obviously you can see their friendship. They've been friends for years, and the chemistry between the two of them, it's like that.
Thanks for coming, Warren.
Yeah, it's fine. I mean, we're friends, and I wasn't going to let another undertaker do this job, you know what I mean? Especially since it's my day off.
So I met Reece about 3 or 4 years ago, before we started uni. And it was funny, because the funny thing we said to each other was, did you bring your passport? That was the induction day? What was it? The day that we had to bring the documents into school. And yeah, and I think from there it's just started, actually, like a friendship and all that. And then you start telling me about his projects, Archie and Jim, showed all his movies, which was, he's really funny, especially Archie and Jim, like, that's so funny, I really like it. Yeah, I met the famous Charlie as well.
Luckily I pushed him off.
And what happened next?
It was over. Alright, the fight was over.
Yeah, it was funny because I actually got into the, I'm going to say that, the character. So we had such a great chemistry, me and Reece, on that movie, because I remember. Yeah, it was a bit emotional, really, because I even cried on the film.
Sober, Warren.
I like the ones we did as well. The rat. There's a rat in my kitchen.
Oh my God. There's a rat in my kitchen. I need to do something. I need to call the police.
I'm a policeman.
Oh, that was quick.
What can I help you for, ma'am?
There's a rat in my kitchen.
A rat in your kitchen?
Yeah, there's a rat in my kitchen.
Isn't that a UB40 song?
What are you all about? There's a rat in my kitchen.
Look, ma'am, calm down. I'm sure it's probably just a squirrel or a vole or something.
No. Does that look like a squirrel or a vole to you?
Wow, that really is a rat. Okay, well, I'll get rid of it while you stay in here while I go and get rid of it for you.
But yeah, it was so funny. Like, this, the dialogue on that, the lines was... It was just like... Every time I watch it, I just think about it.
What's happening?
Oh my God, I am so sorry!
Amazing being part of it all, and just to see that things are going so well for them too. And obviously they will go bigger and bigger. I believe that for sure, that great things are expected there.
Nutmeg! You're alive!
They're like my boys. I absolutely adore them, and of course not only adore them but have so much respect for the work that they do.
You know, at the end of the day, I think they're brilliant actors. The faces, the expressions, and just the utter silliness sometimes is it's got that power just to draw me in.
1 second.
Jim, search Shane and get his ID and any money that has in it.
I couldn't wish for two young men more success. You know, they both deserve it. Their friendship is so solid. They're so committed. I feel very fortunate to have sort of stumbled in their quirky little path. I really, really am so grateful. And again, look, smiling, because I'm thinking about Archie and Jim.
Okay, perfect. Now that we've drugged up the ground, the carrots will start growing better and faster.
And bigger.
Ah, yeah, Jim, that's right. Bigger as well.
Archie, look!
A carrot! A last out of the carrot. Let's pull it out and see if it's fresh.
Yeah!
Jim, do you think you can help us out? It's hard and a bit stiff.
No problem, buddy. Just try and give it a good yank until it comes out.
Are you both done with the penis buns?
No, piss off.
What I like about Charlie and Reece is when they come together, like, the set becomes super vibrant. They really know each other so well that they kind of really bounce off each other's ideas, and all of a sudden something off script and proper improv just kind of appears, which kind of makes it even more fun and exciting and brings that extra kind of character craziness to the screen, which is always fun to have. It's good to have people who kind of know each other well And then you kind of bounce off their ideas, and then you create this, you know, other atmosphere, which then kind of brings about good projects to life, I think.
I'm also grateful to them. They've helped me out in quite a few productions, and always been there, and we've become very good friends, and, you know, may long it continue. You know, what more can I say? Great guys. If you haven't worked with them, have a go, because you will have a lot of fun, if nothing else. You know, you'll enjoy it. They're both gifted, both got a lot of talent, and they're both good guys. Just remember that, okay?
And lots of fun on set, and lots of fist bumps, and lots of pats on the shoulder. You're doing a good job.
Just so passionate and just wanting to do the best job they can, and also just have fun while doing it at the same time. So that's really, so thank you.
A happy 20 years friendship. You've achieved so much together, and long may it continue, and I look forward to being involved in future.
I thought, yeah, I'm going to get on with these two. I'm just as bad.
You may laugh now, but I'm bloody serious.